Since TwinCAT Vision is still a quite new product, I would like to take the opportunity to present its functionality here with our trade fair exhibits. With TwinCAT Vision, we offer an image library that is fully integrated in our engineering and runtime. As it is nowadays standard, the complete configuration, programming, and diagnosis can be done with the same engineering environment like we always use for TwinCAT. We have several assistants that make it easy and fast to integrate and configure a camera. For example, after a network scan, all GigE Vision compatible cameras are listed up and can be chosen with one click. Due to the certified integration of the GigE Vision protocol, this applies for all cameras or manufacturers of different types. Of course, if they support the GigE Vision standard. For the PLC programmer, we offer a very comprehensive vision library as well as a new so-called ADS image watch tool to display the images in the engineering environment. This enables the PLC programmer to completely integrate and program the whole vision functionality himself. If we now take a look at the application behind me, we will see a row that is driven by a servo drive where a sticker is placed on, which several motifs. This represents a continuous material flow. Everything is controlled by our smallest IPC, the C6015, but with the 4-core atom option, which is our entrance level for vision. Because of the same real-time base tick and time calculation, we can synchronize the image acquisition and very precisely to a motion position. Everything is done by the EtherCAT XFC functionality, and in this case the illumination and camera trigger is synchronized by an EL2596 terminal. The camera is connected with an Ethernet cable with the GigE Vision protocol directly to the IPC. On the other side on the wall, you see the XTS application with three different camera manufacturers and also three different camera types. In the middle, we used a laser triangulation sensor, which provides us images with depth information. So we can analyze we can do depth measurement with our library. All is displayed in the HMI, which is available since the beginning. What is new are two HMI controls, especially programmed for vision. We capsuled a lot of functionality within these controls. The image control, for example, provides a toolbar on the top where several actions can be executed. For example, freezing the image, drawing shapes, selecting a zoom level. You can, of course, scale the image or move the image with two finger gestures on the monitor. And on the lower side of the control, you see an info bar where you get the information when you click into the image, where is the pixel position and pixel or color at this pixel position. The color control provides the display of the colors with up to four channels. It's fully configurable so that you can use just one channel, or you can use different inputs or outputs to display the color or to do a color setting. This is just the beginning. Both controls are already available as a pre-release on Nugget, and we will later provide more and more controls. Already at the end of the October, released a new version from TwinCAT Vision. Since this version has so many new functions and optimizations, I just can name a few of them. For example, new possibilities for key point matching, image and contrast optimization by the LUT or Clahé function, calibration of line scans cameras, timestamps for image, or a connected components function for shape analysis. Another highlight of this version is the new assistant for the visualization of init commands. The assistant provides a lot of editable functionality, for example, deselecting single registers, moving up and down, and all the information you is stored in the camera object and automatically downloaded to the camera or sent to the camera when the PLC is started. In this way, we can also guarantee the same functionality for all camera types and manufacturers and guarantee that the camera is always or have always the same settings as done during engineering phase. Another new function, what is now possible, is the integration of images into the TwinCAT scope. That means you can record now the image together with all other machine data and display it and analyze it afterwards.